Yeah, hi friends. Today we are just going to start and introduce a new topic, TensorFlow. And from today onwards, we'll start to be covering the TensorFlow sessions on every day. And the session will be covering, we'll discuss what we are going to cover in next few days. So let's first understand the library, what exactly the TensorFlow is and why we just want to using this. You heard about the word data science nowadays. So basically, TensorFlow is a Google library that provides us the machine learning and deep learning functions, and we'll see what we are covering in this. Okay, so let me just start the warm welcome to all of you, those who are joining the session, and now let's start with the TensorFlow. So basically, what exactly the TensorFlow is? Let's understand it in basic terms. What exactly, let me just explain the term that is defined on the TensorFlow website. Basically, TensorFlow is a library, open source library that is initially developed by Google. And now, basically, this open source library will provide us the end-to-end machine learning more functions and more library functions for pre-processing the data and modeling the data and serving the data. So basically, this library helps the developers to develop and train the machine learning models. So we will go through about this library, how from the very scratch, from very basic, when we learn any programming language, so we'll learn about it, building blocks, we'll learn how to initialize a variable, how to add the variable. So we'll see from the scratch of the TensorFlow what how we can do that in TensorFlow. Okay, so in the today's session, I'm just only giving you the brief about what exactly the TensorFlow is and why we use a TensorFlow, and then next we will discuss about the topics we are covering in the TensorFlow basic sessions. So let's start with why we use a TensorFlow. Basically, as you know, TensorFlow is a library that is provided by Google for writing the machine learning and deep learning models from the scratch. So as you know, this library will help the developers to write not so much code from the scratch. It will do most of the pre-processing, most of the inbuilt functions or wrappers over that machine learning library, so that we just use it and train our models and do it as faster. So basically, why the TensorFlow is popular? The reason is, if I am just, let me just take the pen here. In this slide is not. Okay, basically in the TensorFlow, why it is used, the purpose behind is, machine learning, this TensorFlow library, distributed environment. So we have, if I am assuming I have one system, another system, and I just want to run an inference over the one system, and it will be this system we don't have the so much memory, so I just want to distribute that inferencing part and scale that inferencing part, so that the TensorFlow will be used in the scenarios. So now the TensorFlow will provide more rich functions that will be help to a user to run effectively the machine learning algorithms. Okay, we'll discuss about all of these one by one. So this one is an introductory session. So we'll discuss what exactly we are learning in next couple of sessions. So basically, in the next session, we will discuss about first what exactly the tensor is and how we can create the tensor. And we do the hands-on of creating the tensors and how we can create what exactly the purpose of the tensors, objects, and all this. And how the tensor object is different from the normal object, normal Panda, NumPy objects. Okay. Then we will get into the more detail and description of the TensorFlow, more information about the tensor, and discuss to create the tensor with the help of its attributes. What more attributes we can add it, and what will be the attribute means. For example, if I just want to create an tensor object having an array of 100 elements of integer type. So before starting, whenever we do such kind of operations, we should know about what exactly the tensor object is and what are its attributes. Okay, so after that we are just going to manipulating the tensor object, how we can manipulate the tensor object to some other object, or with the help of some how we can manipulate some various kinds of operations on it. For example, if I have one tensor object, another tensor object, I just want to it multiply, add, subtract, and matrix multiplication, and all these operations we will see in this. And then another session will discuss about how we can convert a tensor object into a NumPy. Okay, then finally we will cover this session in the same part, where we have the @tf. function, what exactly use of this function, and then we will discuss how we can use the GPU or TPU when we create a TensorFlow object, TensorFlow inference, or TensorFlow files. How we can include it, will be included by GPU, it will be included by TPU, and alls. So we can see we can go the overview of GitLab in this part. Okay, so this is the scenario, this is the entire objective of next 1 or 2-3 days that we are going to discuss. So thanks for watching. Thank you.